Gynecomastia surgery is for the reduction of male chest moobs, otherwise known. How common is gynecomastia? It's extremely common. About a third of men have it. We have two types of gynecomastia: the physiological gynecomastia, which is when, by for hormonal reasons, you develop a breast tissue around the time of puberty, or you have the acquired gynecomastia, which is the gynecomastia development of breast tissue that you can get at any point in your life, and that could be because of illness, like hyperthyroidism, for example, causes you gynecomastia. Drugs, steroids, medications for long term. You can have many, many reasons for gynecomastia. It's, as I said, it's extremely common. About a third of men have it. The treatment of it is surgical. People have tried tamoxifen. Usually, people that take steroids try to take tamoxifen to undo the gynecomastia, but it doesn't usually work. And the treatment of gynecomastia is essentially the removal of the breast tissue with the fat that's around it. So it's a combined operation that combines liposuction and direct excision of breast tissue. A lot of people are trying to perform it by just doing vaser surgery. But my experience, and if you want to be correct, you need to say that vaser doesn't really deal with the breast tissue itself. It's not strong enough to break down the breast tissue and remove it. So yes, it works in giving a better contour, but if you want to actually treat the gynecomastia, you need gynecomastia surgery, which could be in combination with vaser or liposuction, but you actually need the breast tissue removed. The operation itself takes about 45 minutes to an hour. It can be done as a day case. Recovery is fairly straightforward. It's one of the few operations where we advise patients to start exercising early, after about 3 weeks. Somebody can go back to work after 1 week, exercise after 3 weeks, and they need to wear a garment, which is quite tight, for about a month. So there is a bit of swelling, a bit of bruising, some discomfort, but overall it's a very good surgery, with minimal complications as well.